using the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem. So you're given this piecewise function and the condition. So first of all, apply the Laplace transform on both sides. Well, before doing that, we need to rewrite this in one line. So how? So I'm gonna use the given step function to do that. So this on the left side gets rewrite it. On the right side, we're gonna start off with t squared, and then at 1, it becomes 0. So to get rid of t squared, we need to subtract t squared. And at this point, the unit step function comes into play, which is u of t minus 1, okay? So that's how you rewrite it in one line. And then, now, if you take a step further, if you're about to take the Laplace transform of this one, the t has to match up with me, and in this case, you cannot take the Laplace transform because the t doesn't match. So in order to take the Laplace transform, we need to make the t match up, which is t minus 1. So in order to do that, I just make it. Okay? And then I need to fix it by adding 1. Okay, so let's take a look at this one. So I subtract 1 and then I added 1. Which means I literally add 0, right? So t minus 1 plus 1 still is t squared. Alright, now distribute this out in a certain way. So distribute t minus 1 as a group. Okay? So I have t minus 1 squared u of t minus 1 plus or minus 2 t minus 1 u of t minus 1 minus u of t minus 1. Okay? So you may wonder why, how I get this one. Well, if you have a plus b squared, you're gonna have a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, and in this case, my a is t minus 1 and b is 1. And the reason I have a negative sign because I distributed the negative in front, okay? Now, we can take the Laplace transform easily. Let me rewrite this first. So on the left side, I have this one. On the right side, I have 2 over s cubed minus this one, 2 over s cubed e to the negative s minus 2 over s e to the negative s minus 1 over s e to the negative s. Okay? Okay, let's see. Now on the left side, I group this together and factor capital Y of s out. On the right side, just rewrite these. And for this one, y of 0 equals 1, negative 1, move to the right, positive 1. Okay? Now divide both sides by s minus 5. Now I need to be careful because the s and the 5 look similar to each other. So watch carefully, okay? And I will write it carefully, so that you won't get confused. Alright. So for this one, and this one, they say exactly the same. This one you can use shortcut, shortcut, shortcut. Oh, okay. Oh, shoot. Go back to this one, so you have 2 over s squared. My bad. Oh, okay, s cubed, s squared, s. Alright, good. Now let me work it on a separate sheet. Let me move this up. Alright. So for this one, partial fraction decomposition method to get fractions of these. Okay? So at this level, you definitely know how to find the partial fraction, so I'm not gonna go over it in order to save time. But I will show all of my work here, so that you can follow what I'm doing, okay? Alright, now you have A, B, C, D. That's for this one. And for this one as well. Now for this one. Let me include the negative side as well. For this one, again, using partial fraction decomposition method to get the fractions of these. So I just speed this up. Now for this one, I'm going to do it here. So if you haven't had the chance to watch the video that I made about finding partial fraction in less than 30 seconds, I'll put the link in the upper right corner here so that you can go to watch that video. It's very simple and helps you a lot in this case like this. So using that shortcut, I will have something over S plus something over S minus 5. And as you can see, they are off by 5, so I have 1/5 on the top. And the next step is to determine which one has the negative sign. As I experienced, the bigger denominator, which is this one, will carry the negative sign. So very quickly I get the fractions for these. Alright, now let's rewrite this. So this becomes negative 2 over 125 all over S plus negative 2 over 25 over S squared plus negative 2 over 5 over S cubed plus D is 2 over 125 over S minus 5 for this one. Similar like this one, but you have the negative out front. So just bring this down. Don't forget to multiply by e to the negative s. Now for this one, you have it down here, so I have 2 over 25 over s plus b, 2 over 5 s squared c negative 2 over 25 s minus 5 e to the negative s. Okay, now for the third term, I have negative 1/5 over S plus 1 over 5 S minus 5 E to the negative S plus 1 over S minus 5. Alright. Oh, you see there's a lot of terms here. Let's combine items if you can. This one. Can do anything with all these. Just rewrite all those. Whoosh. Okay, now for these, for e to the s, let me use a different color here. Oh, bad. So this one, you can combine them together. Shoot. Let's see, what it gives me. 2 over 125 plus 1 over plus 1. So 1.7. Over 125 over S minus 5, okay? Now for all these. So I would definitely have this should be the negative as well, okay? So let's see what I have. 2 over 125 plus 2 over 25 plus 1 over 5, that gives me 37 over 125 all over S. Okay, that's for S. Now for S squared, I have two terms. Negative 2 over 25, positive 2 plus 2 over 5 12 over 25. That's weird. Now for S cubed. So just S cubed. So just rewrite it. Negative 2 over 5 S cubed. S minus 5. So you're gonna have a lot of things here. S minus 5. S minus 5. And S minus 5 over here. Oh, there's a lot of circles here, so hopefully you won't get confused. 2 over 125. Negative. Negative 2 over 25. Oh, dates, that's one positive, okay, because you distributed negative. Negative 2 over 25, minus 2 over 25. Minus. 1/5. Negative 37 over 125 over S minus 5 multiplied by e to the negative S, right? Now it's time to take the L inverse on both sides, so apply that L inverse on both sides. I have y of t equals this one, negative 2 over 125 minus 2 over 25 t minus 2 minus 1 over 5 S squared. The reason I have one negative 1 over 5 squared is because for SQ, the L inverse of this is negative 2 over 5 divided by 2y, because when you take the Laplace transform of this one, you're gonna have 2 over SQ, right? 2 over SQ and 2 negative 2 divided. So the negative 2 divided by 2, which is 1, right? So that gives me negative 1 over 5. Well, if you don't make sense, you can take the Laplace transform of this one, and it gives you negative 2 over 5 over S cubed, right? Because this one goes forward 2 over S cubed times 1 over 5, negative 2 over 5, okay? Hope that makes sense. Alright, now for the last term, I have 1.7 over 125 e to the negative 5t, okay? Now for the e. So I'm going to have everything multiplied by u of t minus 1 by the unit step function, okay? And for this one, we have 37 over 125 plus 12 over 25 t minus 1 plus 2 over 5 and 1 over 5 again. This is similar to this one. So 1 over 5 e to the of t minus 1 squared plus 1 plus 37 over 125 e to the e to the positive 5 t minus 1, okay? So the reason you have t minus 1 because you have this unit step function, so all of the t's have to match up with this one. That's why I have t minus 1 here and here, okay? Without a unit step function, you just have something like this. Oh, this should be t squared. You would have something like this, okay? And this is your final solution eventually. Right here should be negative. Just bring that a negative, okay? Alright, that should be your final answer. That's it! If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.